Okay, good morning to all the students. I am Kalpana teacher from Nehru Nagar English Municipal School. So students, as you know that whole world is facing a disease that is coronavirus, and we are also taking so many precautions like, you know, wearing the mask, then washing our hands, using sanitizer, everything. We are taking preventive measures to avoid it. And also, you know, that a person who is having a very strong immune system, okay, the virus is having very less or not much effect on that person. So immune system means like the ability to attack, okay, the ability to defeat the foreign bodies. So if a person is having a very strong immune system, so this virus is not having much effect on that person. So, and also we are taking so many precautionary measures. So like COVID-19 is one of the disease that spreads due to virus. So students, today we will learn about various diseases, its symptoms, and what are the precautions that we can take to avoid such diseases. So today I'm going to teach you science, and the lesson is health and diseases. So we are doing a revision of this chapter. Also, students, if you like our channel, so please subscribe the channel. The link is given in the chat box. So let me share my screen with you.
Madam, unmute yourself.
Okay, students, have you ever taken leave from the school? Okay, when you feel sick. So exactly what happens when you feel sick or when you become sick? Like you may have stomachache or headache, okay, then slightly fever also you may get. So sometimes students, you know what happens, like you feel good even without taking any type of medicine, but sometimes you need to consult the doctor, and you have to take regular medicine to prevent sickness, okay, you have to take the proper consultation of the doctor when you become sick, okay. So our today's topic is health and diseases. So let's study what is health. Now students, what is health? Health is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-beingness. Okay, it is not any absence of disease. It is what? It when you are physically, mentally, and socially active. Okay, physically also you are good, mentally also you are very active without any kind of stress, and socially, that is among your friends and family, you are also very well behaving. So that means you are in a healthy state. Now, students, what is disease? Disease means what? Any disturbances. Okay, any kind of disturbances that happens physiologically or psychologically in your body. Okay, now what is physiological and psychological? So physiological means what, students? Physiological is a branch of biology that deals with the normal functions of living organisms and their parts. So whenever there is some problem in your body, okay, or in any of your body parts, so that branch deals with physiological. And psychological means what? Whenever there is any problem, okay, or the branch that deals with mental or emotional state of a person. So whenever a person is not physically fit or mentally fit, that is any disturbances that happens to a person, physiological or psychological. So that means the person is having or he or she is suffering from any kind of disease. Now, students, like there are so many types of diseases, and you have also heard like few diseases like diabetes, common cold, asthma, and heart diseases. Now, types of diseases, like diseases are of various types. So it is divided into two categories. The first one is according to duration and the second one is according to reason. Now, according to duration, it is divided as chronic disease and acute disease. Chronic disease means what? It may, be for a long time, like for years. And acute disease means it is for very short time, but actually the pain and the suffering is too much. Then according to reasons, it may be hereditary disease, that is from parent to child, and acquired disease that we acquire, okay, from surrounding, or we acquire from other viruses, bacteria. Now, acquired diseases may be classified as infectious diseases and non-infectious diseases. Now, let us study about all these types of diseases and few diseases in detail. Now, students, you see how diseases are actually spreading. So how all these types of diseases spread? Now, in previous chapter, you know that there are so many microorganisms that are present in the atmosphere, in the air. Okay, so there are harmful microorganisms also, and there are harmless microorganisms also. So students, when these microorganisms, that harmful microorganisms, they cause disease, they are known as pathogens. And when these pathogens, they enter in a body from an infected person to a healthy person, okay, by direct or indirect transmission. So when it is transmitted from an infected person to a healthy person, so it spreads diseases. So these pathogens which are present in the atmosphere, they enter in the body and infect the people. Now, let's learn what is infectious diseases. Now, infectious diseases are what, students? Diseases which spread through contaminated air, food, water, or vectors. Vectors means it may be insects or other animals, okay, like housefly and other animals. So, insects. So, these are known as infectious diseases. Now, some examples of infectious diseases are like tuberculosis, dysentery, typhoid, cholera, jaundice. Okay, so these are few examples that falls under category of infectious diseases. Now, students, you see that mosquitoes are present everywhere. Okay, so now we will see one of the diseases that spreads due to mosquito. So the disease that spreads due to mosquito is dengue. Now you can see in this picture, students, like a mosquito, it lays eggs in waterlogged places. Now these are the few waterlogged places you can see over here, like a bin, thrown cans and bottles, then unused tires, okay, flower waste. So these mosquitoes actually lays the eggs in these waterlogged places, and thereby they increase their population. Now, different kinds of mosquitoes actually spread different diseases. Now, this dengue is spread by a mosquito, female mosquito, that is Aedes, and also it belongs to a flavivirus, that is a type flavivirus, and it is caused by dengue virus, that is DEN 1-4 virus. Okay. Now, if something happens to you, or if you get any kind of disease, so there are some symptoms that actually let you know that which type of disease you are suffering from. So let's see what are the symptoms of dengue. So what are the symptoms of dengue? Like the patient is having high fever, then he is having muscle and joint pain, then vomiting is also one of the symptoms. Also rashes on the skin and pain behind the eye sockets. The person may have severe headache and also bleeding from mouth and nose. So these are the symptoms if a person is suffering from dengue. So he will get these kind of symptoms. Also, there is a decrease in platelet count, which leads to internal bleeding. So students, what you have to do, you have to, you'd have to avoid the places where the water is logged. Also, you must keep the water clean at your home, at your places. Okay. Don't allow the mosquito to lay the eggs. Now, infectious diseases, like I told you, infectious diseases, they spread due to insects and also animals. So let's see a disease which spreads due to pigs. And viruses. Okay, students, now viruses are what? Viruses are small living organisms. Okay, they cannot replicate without a host cell. So it needs a host cell, like diseases that are caused, like viruses are rabies, swine flu, and Ebola. Also, right now, coronavirus is going on. And also, there is no cure for a virus, but vaccination can prevent it from spreading. So like I told you, the infectious diseases, like it spreads to animals. So we will see one of the diseases. It spreads due to pigs, that is swine flu. Now, students, now swine flu, it actually spreads from pigs to human beings. What is swine flu? Swine flu is infection. Okay, it is an infection which is caused by influenza virus, also known as H1N1, which infects the respiratory tract of the pigs. Okay, the respiratory system that we breathe. So it infects the respiratory tract of the pigs, and then the virus mutates and doubles, and it becomes easily transmitted from humans. So from pigs to pigs, from pigs to human beings, and from human beings to human beings. Such a way the swine flu is spread. Now, why the swine flu is spread and what are the reasons of infection? So infection of the swine flu occurs through pigs and humans, as you know. And the reasons are it actually gets infected from the sweat of a person who is infected. Also through the secretions of the nose, then throat and saliva. Okay, so a person who is infected, okay, who is having already a swine flu. So it is transferred from a person in all these four modes. Now, what are the symptoms? If a person is suffering from swine flu, how you will come to know that he is suffering from that particular disease? So the person who is suffering from swine flu, he will have difficulty in breathing, then sore throat, and the body will have lot of pain. Now, if to diagnose any disease, you have to conduct tests. Okay, so that's why swine flu. So to diagnose swine flu also, what is done? the throat of a liquid, okay? The liquid from a throat of a person or a patient is sent in the laboratory. And the diagnostic facilities, that is diagnostic centers, are available in National Institute of Virology, that is in Pune, and National Institute of Communicable Disease, that is in New Delhi. Now, next disease is AIDS. So, the full form of AIDS is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Now, students, this disease is a viral disease, and this disease is caused by a virus, that is human immunodeficiency virus. Now, what happens, as I already told you, the immune system, whenever a person is having a very strong immune system, so that time the foreign bodies or other diseases, that it is not having much effect on that person. So what the HIV virus actually does, it weakens the natural immune system of a patient or of a person. And when the immune system of a person becomes weak, so other diseases, other various kind of diseases, they come and attack the body. And the person actually suffers from so many other types of diseases. The person who is having HIV, he actually suffers from other various kind of diseases due to the weakening of the natural immunity. So this is a HIV virus. Now the person, he may suffer from various other diseases, like he may have common liver infections, also very rare, means easily infected by tuberculosis, and he may have prolonged fever. Now, as I already told you that there are various tests to diagnose different types of diseases. So to diagnose AIDS, ELISA test is done, and the symptoms, ELISA test is done, and it is also done in proper laboratory. And the symptoms of the AIDS are person specific, that is different type of, means it is not like one particular symptoms, different patients or different person may get different kind of symptoms. I have shared few symptoms with you, like the student who is suffering from HIV may have muscle aches, chills, mouth ulcers, fever, sore throat, then fatigue, night sweats, swollen lymph nodes, and skin rashes. Now, how it is transmitted? So students, HIV AIDS is transmitted via unprotected sex, then use of drugs, if you are using drugs or syringe, then blood transfusion from infected blood goes, get transferred to a healthy person, pregnancy, like from a pregnant mother to a child, also using the non-sterile instruments. And students, you should always remember that AIDS does not cause, or it do not occur by touching hands or sharing food, by shaking hands with an infected person. So our behavior with the HIV infected person must be normal. And the HIV was first reported in an African species of monkeys. Now, students, you all love dogs, okay? And most people, they keep dogs as their pet. But what happens when dogs bite you? Okay, is there any disease that is caused by, dog bite? So this is one of the disease, that is rabies, that is caused by dog bite. Now, students, this rabies is a viral disease, and it occurs to the bite of infected dog, then rabbit, monkey, cat, and any other animals. Okay, so these rabies, actually it occurs due to the bite of all these animals. What happens when the infected animals actually bite you? So when an infected animal bites you, the virus enters the brain. The virus actually enters the brain via neurons, and person is having very extreme fear of water, which is known as hydrophobia. This is one of the symptom of rabies, that is the person is having very extreme fear of water. And students, rabies is a fatal disease, but it can be prevented by timely vaccination. And the symptoms start to appear within 90 to 170 days of a dog bite. Now let's see what are the symptoms. As I already told you, the fever, hydrophobia is one of the symptoms. Also, the person will have fever for 2 to 12 weeks. Then exaggeration in the behavior. Exaggeration means what? The fact of making something seem larger. Okay, actually making any situation seem larger or worse, better or worse than actually it is. And hydrophobia, that is extreme fear of water. Now we have seen few infectious diseases. Now let's see what are non-infectious diseases. First, let's see what do you mean by non-infectious disease. So diseases which do not occur through infections, okay, and body contacts. It does not occur through any kind of infections or body contacts are known as non-infectious diseases. And such a type of diseases, students, they arise in the human body itself. You know, they arise itself because of some other reasons. Now let's see what are those reasons. You can see in this picture, like there are various diseases on the leaves, like heart disease and stroke, then diabetes, cancer, chronic lung disease. So these are diseases which are actually non-infectious diseases. And the root cause is what? That is, these are the reasons in red color, that physical inactivity, alcohol, that is use of alcohol, then tobacco, and also they are having an unhealthy diet. So nowadays, so many people, they are suffering from cancer. Like recently, Sanjay Dutt was also diagnosed by cancer. So let's see what is cancer. So cancer is what, students? It is uncontrolled and abnormal cell growth in the is called a cancer. So what happens, just look at this picture. First picture, you can see it is a normal, that is the cell growth is normal, that is regulated cell growth. And second picture, you can see that is in between, there is uncontrolled cell growth. That means the cells are growing uncontrollably. So these uncontrolled and abnormal cell growth is called cancer, which becomes, you know, cancerous cells and lump. Also, it becomes tumor. Now, there are so many different types of cancer, like lungs cancer, then mouth and tongue cancer, then stomach cancer, breast cancer, then skin cancer and blood cancer. So there are so many different types of cancer. Now, why this type of diseases happens or it comes in your body? So reasons are consumption of tobacco. So you must not use tobacco because it may lead to cancer. Also, students, you should not eat gutka and you should not smoke, use of alcohol. So you should never use all these things, okay, or consume all these things, as it may lead to cancer. And lack of fiber content, that is lack of fruits and vegetables. If you are not having a proper diet also, then it may affect your body. And then consumption of junk food. Nowadays, students, everybody is liking, you know, pizza, burger and other things. So all these things are junk food. So you must avoid these junk foods and must have healthy diet. And heredity may be reason, heredity like from parent to child. So these are all the reasons that causes cancer. So you must avoid all these things. Now, what are the symptoms if a person is suffering from a cancer? So symptoms are like chronic cough, then the hoarse voice and difficulty in swallowing. Whenever a person is eating something, so he is having difficulty in swallowing the things. And incurable scar, any scar that has happened is not curing. It is, you know, the same, it is same for a long time. And so much inflammation is there on that scar. Then there are lumps in the breast. You can see the lumps over here. That is the uncontrolled cell that has growth abnormally. Then unexplained weight loss, that is sudden weight loss. Now, what you can do to prevent such type of disease? Because you know such type of disease don't occur from the surrounding or any infection. So what you can do is, it's in our hands. So what you can do is, you must have a controlled diet, means eat healthy fruits and vegetables, okay? Avoid all type of junk food, then exercise regularly. Nowadays, what happens, students, like everybody is having some kind of routine, okay? So in that routine, they don't do exercise at all. So you must regularly do exercise. And you must avoid eating gutka, and you must not smoke also. Okay, so all these are the things you must do to prevent such type of diseases like cancer. Okay, so now students, you may have any of the, you know, relative or at your home that you're suffering from diabetes. So let's learn more about it and why it happens and how actually you can prevent it. Okay. So there are modern diagnostic treatments also done to treat the cancer, like various techniques like CT scan and MRI scan. Also mammography is done, then biopsy are used to diagnose the cancer. So these are the modern diagnostic diagnostic that is done for cancer. Also, there are some, treatment like chemotherapy, then radiation therapy, modern techniques like robotic and laparoscopic surgery. So these are the modern treatment of cancer, like how to treat a cancer. So these are the modern equipments and treatment available. Now let's see diabetes. So diabetes is what actually, students? Now you can see in this picture, the orange color, that is the pancreas. Now this pancreas that is inside your body, it produces a hormone known as insulin, okay, which controls the sugar and glucose level in your blood. Now what happens, now when this hormone, that is insulin, is secreted in low quantity, so the glucose level is cannot be controlled. And when the glucose level is not controlled, so this disorder leads to diabetes. Okay, so what causes diabetes? When this inside the pancreas a hormone is produced, that is insulin, and that controls the sugar and glucose level in your blood. And when this level of, that is insulin level, is secreted in low quantity, so the glucose level cannot be controlled, which leads to diabetes. Now, what are the symptoms of diabetes, or what you should not ignore? Okay, the symptoms of diabetes are, the person who is suffering from diabetes may have, you know, frequent urination at night, then increased weight loss or decreased weight loss. Okay, that is increased weight loss, that is obesity, or sudden decreased weight loss. Now, what are the reasons of diabetes? As I already told you, you must follow a proper healthy diet. So first one is like heredity. So heredity means from parent, from a child. If a parent is suffering from diabetes, there are more chances that a child may also suffer from the same disease. Second one is obesity. Then lack of physical exercise and mental stress. Okay, so all these things are there. So what are, now let's see what are the preventive measures you have to take. First, what you have to do, first you have to follow a proper diet for all type of diseases. If you have to avoid, you must always, you know, have a proper and healthy diet. Okay, so following a proper diet, and also along with the medicines. If a person is having diabetes, then he must properly take medicines regularly, and he or she must exercise under the supervision of the doctor. Okay, so these are the diseases. Now next one is heart disease. Nowadays, you know what happens, like people are not eating proper food and having a very bad lifestyle, because of which they are facing so many heart problems. So let's see heart diseases. So students, heart supplies blood in all the organs of your body. Now what happens? The efficiency of the heart is decreased due to the decreased blood supply. Okay, the heart is continuously pumping. So the efficiency of the heart actually decreases. Why decreases? Because there is a very less blood supply in the heart. And when there is a less blood supply in the heart, so less oxygen and nutrients is supplied to the heart. So what the heart has to do, it has to perform more work. And when you have to perform more work, what happens? More stress you get. So when the same way, what happens when the heart is performing more work? So it's leading more stress to it. So when there is more stress, when the heart gets more stress, what happens? You cause a heart attack. So if someone is having heart attack, so please immediate consultation of the doctor is necessary. Now let's see what are the symptoms you should never ignore, or you should not ignore if a person is having these symptoms. So please don't ignore. He may have some kind of heart disease, like severe chest pain, then pain in shoulder, neck and arms, also cramps in the hands. The person may feel, you know, uneasiness and tremors. Okay, that shaking of hands and fingers. Then what are the reasons of heart attack? Heart attack may cause due to smoking, then use of alcohol. If a person is already a diabetic person, then the chances of getting heart diseases also increases. Okay, so then hypertension, that is high blood pressure, obesity, also lack of physical exercise, then heredity, like from parent to child. If a parent is having a heart disease, the chances of having heart disease to a child also increases. Then mental stress, anger and anxiety. So all these are the reasons of heart attack. So to avoid any kind of disease, students, you must lead a peaceful life. You should not take so much stress, okay? And you must follow a proper diet. Now, the treatment, what are the treatments actually you have to do when a person is suffering from heart disease? Now, there are so many different kinds of treatment. The first one is like heart bypass surgery or coronary artery bypass graft surgery. Now, in this surgery, the flow of the blood, like what happens, there is a decreased blood supply to the heart. So, by this surgery, the blood flow of the heart is improved. Second one is open heart surgery. Now this is also known as sometimes, you know, traditional heart surgery. In this surgery, the heart is, you know, the chest is cut open and the surgery is performed, and the valves and the arteries of the heart, you know, are performed. The surgery is performed on the valves and the arteries of the heart, and thereby increasing the efficiency of the heart. Third one is installation of the stents. You can see in this picture, there are three types of various stents here. So what is a stent, student? So stent is actually a tiny tube that is inserted in your airlock passage. So when the passages are blocked and there is less supply to the oxygen to your heart, so this stent actually, it opens the passage and it restores the flow of the blood. Okay, and it depends on where it is actually placed. Now, these stents are made of metal or plastic, and it is made of a special fabric. Next one is angioplasty. In angio, what happens? The fats actually get accumulated in the arteries and valves. So you can see in this picture. So doing the angioplasty, the blood flow is again restored through the artery. Then a heart transplant. Heart transplant was, you know, by doing a surgery, the diseased heart, okay, the heart which is not properly functioning is removed from that person body, and it is replaced from a healthy donor. It is replaced from a healthy heart. Then installation of pacemaker. Now, what is pacemaker? You can see in this picture. So a pacemaker is electrically charged medically device. Okay, now it is implanted under the skin to manage the irregular heartbeats. Whenever a person or a patient is having irregular heartbeat due to decreased blood supply or flow of the blood, so this pacemaker is what actually it does. It actually manages the heartbeats and makes it regular. Now, students, what happens, you know, people nowadays, they take medicine without any prescription. Like if I am having some kind of fever, I usually what I will think, like I will not go to doctor and I will take any kind of medicine which I know will cure my fever. So this way you misuse the medicine. This way people are misusing the medicine, and we are taking medicine without any prescription, proper prescription from the doctor. So what happens, we don't know like how much quantity of medicine we have to take. So these overdose of medicines, they affect our body. So you must not, you know, take medicines without proper prescription from the doctor. So what happens when you take the overuse of medicines? So when you take that overdose of medicines or painkillers, so it affects your nervous system, it affects your excretory system, it affects your liver also. So overdose of antibiotics, like whatever antibiotics we are taking along with the fever or along with other medicines, so these type of antibiotics may also, you know, lead to stomach ache, dysentery, then rash, and also white patches on the tongue. So please, students, avoid taking medicines without any prescription of doctor. Please take medicines only when doctor has prescribed you. Okay. Now what happens, students, like nowadays medicines are very costly, and people, you know, they do not afford the costly medicines. So there must be, you know, some kind of alternative for such thing. So that's why generic medicines are there. Now, what are generic medicines? These generic medicines are also known as general medicines, and they are manufactured and distributed without any patent. Okay. And these medicines, you know, they are also in a good quality, like branded medicines. The only thing is there is not any kind of brand in this. And the production cost of these medicines are also very low. And why it is very low? Because of the fewer expenses, okay, that is done in the research, because the formula of the medicine is already available, and that's why the production cost is very less. So the poor people who cannot afford, you know, branded medicines, they can use generic medicines. Okay, it is very easily available in the market also, and you can nowadays, you know, like there are so many apps here that you can order, like a health card app. So you can also download these apps from the mobile, and you can order the generic medicines, which are very cheap. Now you should know that Government of India has declared Pradhan Mantri Jan Anushiddhi Yojana on 1st July 2015. In this scheme, you know, the best quality medicines are made available in affordable prices to citizens, like the students, people who cannot afford medicines which are very, you know, costly. So under this Yojana, what the government has declared that government is actually giving medicines in affordable prices to the citizens. Also, Jan Anushuddhi stores are launched for this purpose. Now, lifestyle and diseases. Students, lifestyle means what? Lifestyle means your daily routine. What you do daily, what kind of food you eat, how you actually live. Okay, so that means your lifestyle. Now, lifestyle is related to diseases. Like what kind of lifestyle you are living, that depends, means what type of lifestyle you are living. Actually, if you are having a good lifestyle, then you are having a healthy life. But if your lifestyle is bad, okay, if your lifestyle is not good, it is poor, then it may lead to various kinds of diseases. So nowadays, what happens, students, like everybody is using mobile phone. Okay, so because of that, they are having, you know, habit of staying in bed late night, and also morning also they are not waking up properly. So these are the changes that has happened right now. Then also frequent changes in the meal time, like you are eating anytime. There is no proper timing to eat the food. Okay, so all these are also lack of physical exercise. People are avoiding physical exercise and consumption of junk food. Instead of eating healthy food, people are eating nowadays junk food. So this kind of lifestyle has become nowadays. And because of this kind of lifestyle, what happens? We are, having such type of diseases, and the diseases have increased, and people are getting sick very frequently. So if you don't have to get sick, please follow a proper lifestyle to avoid diseases. Okay. So if the frequency of becoming sick, you have to lower the frequency. So proper follow lifestyle. Now, what is a proper lifestyle? Actually, what you will follow? So what you have to do is you must have sufficient sleep, then exercise regularly, have proper diet, then do yoga and pranayam. Along with the physical exercise, you can do yoga and pranayam also. That is very good for our body. And students, physical exercise you must do at your own capacity, like how much exercise you can do or your body can tolerate. So according to that only you should exercise. You should not exercise too much or too less. Okay, so you know your capacity, according to that you must exercise regularly. Now, Health Awareness Day, let me share a few of the some of the dates like health awareness to create awareness of the health. So students, 7th April is World Health Day. Then 29th September is known as World Heart Day. 14th June, World Blood Donation Day. And 14th November is World Diabetic Day. Now, students, what happens, whenever the patient is having some kind of surgery or other thing, so there is, lack of blood. So what you have to do, donate the blood. Okay, so blood donation is very important. Why you have to donate the blood, students? Because, if one person is donating a blood, it could save up to 3 lives. Okay, why, how it can save up to 3 lives? For example, that inside your blood there are RBCs, that is red blood corpuscles, WBC, white blood corpuscles, and platelets. So this way you can save, if a person is donating, if one person is donating a blood, so it could save up to 3 lives. Okay, so if you are a healthy person, so you must donate the blood. So now let's answer few of the questions which we have studied in the chapter. So first one is define infectious disease. So students, what do you mean by infectious disease?
Non-infectious disease means that do not infect with body contact and with some kinds of food and water. It cannot spread from that thing.
Yes, yes. So that is non-infectious disease. I am asking about infectious disease. What is infectious disease? I'm asking infectious disease, like you said, non-infectious disease do not spread
disease spread to contaminated water, air, and food and vectors, insects and other animals is called infectious disease.
Yes, very good, very good. Now tell me, can you tell me some of the non-infectious diseases, names of non-infectious disease which do not spread through body contacts and all, names?
Like cancer,
yes,
diseases, it's developed from our body only.
Yes, yes. Okay, very good, very good. Now, tell me two symptoms of heart disease. Now, if a person is suffering from heart disease, what the person will have, what symptom the person will have if a person is suffering from heart disease? What kind of symptoms he will have?
Severe chest pain.
Yes, severe chest.
Headache.
Yes, yes.
No, no, not headache. Headache.
Severe chest pain.
No. Cramps yes, in hands yes, yes. And
very good. Cramps in the hands, neck, shoulder. Okay, very good. Now, if you have to treat the heart disease, what are the modern methods to treat the heart disease? We have seen, you know, few of the methods to treat the heart disease.
Bypass surgery, open heart surgery.
Yes, very good.
Installation of stent.
Yes, yes. Installation of a stent. Very nice. Very nice. Okay. Now, if a person is suffering from cancer, what are the preventive measures? Like how you can prevent cancer?
How doing can exercise.
Very nice.
Doing
very
exercise, nice. Eating diet food, not junk food.
Yes, yes. Proper healthy
and
food.
Taking, yes, and taking medicines for that.
Yes, very good. What's your name, student?
Tejasvi Radhesham Chaurasia.
Very good, Tejasvi. Very good.
From Goshala Marga, MPS School.
Very nice. Very nice. Now, what is the full form of AIDS?
AIDS.
Yes, yes. Acquired. What is the full form of AIDS, students?
Acquired immune disease syndrome.
Yes, very good.
Acquired immune disease syndrome.
Acquired immune.
Very nice.
Infancy syndrome.
Now, student, what causes rabies? What causes rabies?
Virus.
Very
virus.
Nice. Now, what is the full form of HIV? What is the full form of HIV?
Human immune deficiency virus.
Human immune deficiency virus. Very nice. You students are all doing great. Now, what are the symptoms of swine flu? You can see four options over here. What are the symptoms of swine flu? Of swine flu,
cough and sore throat.
Yes, cough and sore throat. Very nice. Now, to which of the following disease HIV virus leads to? When a person is having HIV virus, so which disease actually it leads to?
AIDS.
Very nice. Very nice. Which infective organ is responsible for dengue? For dengue, which actually infective organism or which microorganism is responsible for dengue?
Virus.
Yes, students. Very good. Very good. Now, which of these is a symptom of HIV infection? When a person is having HIV infection, what symptoms the person is having? Can you tell me?
Fever. All of the above.
All of the above. Yes, very good.
All of the above.
The person is having all these three symptoms like fever, tiredness, swollen lymph nodes. Very nice. Now, what is swine flu? Swine flu is what? Which happens to the pigs? From the pigs, it spreads.
Respiratory disease.
Yes. Actually, swine flu is a respiratory disease that affects pigs. Very nice. You students are doing a great job. Now, why are a healthy diet and your exercise so important if you have diabetes? If a person is having diabetes, why a healthy diet and regular exercise is important? Tell me, to keep pressure at bay.
It raises blood sugar. Excesses lower it.
Okay.
Answer D, B, and C.
B and C. Yes, very nice. If a person is having diabetes, So if regular exercise is not done, it raises the blood sugar and also sugar people become more overweight. Now, which of the following disease is not a non-communicable? Non-communicable means non-infectious disease. Which of the disease is infectious? Non-infectious disease?
Cancer. Flu. Cancer.
Very good. Very
cancer.
Good. Now, students, AIDS is caused by HIV. Okay. So now these the among of the following, which one is not a mode of transmission? Like four options are given. From that four, one is not a mode
shaking hands. Shaking hands with infected person.
Shaking hands and infected person.
Very good. Shaking hands with infected person.
Shaking hands with infected person.
Not here.
Googly.
Not transmitted. Now, which is not a symptom of diabetes? Among these, which is not a symptom? Okay, not. Not a symptom of diabetes.
Thirst. Thirst.
Not a symptom. Yes, thirst. Okay, thirst. Very nice. Very nice.
Thirst.
And insulin is a hormone secreted by which organ or gland? Insulin is secreted
pancreas.
By very the pancreas. Nice. Students, you all are very intelligent. Pancreas. Now, where did HIV originate? As I told you, HIV has originated from a type of species.
A chimpanzee.
Yes, very nice. A chimpanzee. That is, HIV was first reported in an African species of monkey. Now, symptoms of heart attack can include. Okay, what are the symptoms of heart attack? Like dizziness, weakness in arm pain, pressure. Then,
A. This has weakness, arm pain.
All of the above? No, not all of the above.
All of the above will not
A
come.
And B. A yes. And B, both.
A and B.
Yes, A and B can come. Okay, shortness of the breath. Very good. Now, next is, a person suffering from dengue may show excessive bleeding. Is it true or false? If a person is suffering from dengue, may show
false.
Excessive
bleeding. False.
False. False.
Is it false? Yes, students, is it false?
Yes.
See, if a person is suffering from dengue, you know, there may be a bleeding from the nose and the mouth. Okay. Also, because of the decrease in the platelet count, it may lead to internal bleeding. So, if a person is suffering from dengue, it may lead to excessive bleeding. So, this statement is actually true.
True.
Okay. True.
Now, risk for heart disease include. What are the risks that for heart disease include? What are the that high blood pressure and high cholesterol, smoking, lack of exercise? What you do?
All of the above.
Yes.
All of the above.
Next question is, which infective organism is responsible for dengue? Okay, this we have already done, I think.
It is. Virus?
Yes, virus. So now next is, cancer is the result of uncontrolled growth of abnormal cells anywhere in the body. Is this
true?
Very nice. Cancer is because of abnormal and uncontrolled growth of the cells in body. So thank you, students. I hope you enjoyed the lesson and you understood various types of diseases. And you students are very active and intelligent. You have answered all the questions. Okay. So if you like, if you want more such type of videos, please like and subscribe our BMC channel so that you will get more educational videos and you will learn more. So once again, I thank you all the students for joining here and showing active participation.